cut off the arm of this authority president. Without mind, he was just singing and moving. Then what he is going to do with that cut arm, which is bloodshedding in his hands? Immediately, the fellow got trembling and shivering fear, and he informed the Sadashiv Prabhupada that his arm has been very honestly, systematically amputated by the rogue. He has confessed. Then Sadashiv Prabhupada, he did not say anything, just keep it and go away, okay, sorry, thank you. So he just kept and he was going there. It is a moment of trance. And those who are in immobile trance, for them also, why I am saying this, even though trance is a spiritual attribute, a person in deepest spiritual attribute, for example, if I am having a good incense stick that will permeate the puja room, if it is more fragrant, it will permeate the whole room. If somebody is cooking something, with spice or something, the whole street will be made spicy and juicy. Likewise, it is not a permeation. Quality of eternity and undisturbability is an attribute of soul, not body. Whenever the spiritual progress is more, this quality permeates to the body also. The body is equally imperishable as the soul. And you know that the Nainam Chintanti Shastrani, Nainam Dahati Pavaka, it is for soul. But for Prahlada, when he was harassed by his parents, by his father, then he was just targeted with missiles, he was put into fire. All these treatments have been for his body. But it did not work out. Even though the spiritualistic attitudes are different, in over spiritual progress and realization, the attitudes are permeating, they are overlapping in the body also. So this also, so there is known as benefit of trance. And third is elixir. It may be aushada or anaushada. It may be due to some medicines, or even without any medicines, youth, energy and longevity is known as elixir, kalpa. Those who are having kalpa sharira, they have perennial youth, perennial dynamism and disease freeness and also longevity, extended longevity. So these things are physical paranormal phenomena. Then what is oral paranormal phenomena? We are seeing lot of things like benediction. What is a blessing? Potential wish of a person passed to a sincere, able and compatible receptor is known as benediction. And malediction is a curse, which is known as evil eye, etc. I have already told in one lecture that even if your parents, it won't work out. Because parents and their instinctive attachment towards the children's progress is naturally common with cockroach, rats, everybody, etc. So unless the parents, they have penance, austerity, honesty and good attributes, the attributes along with their wish, potential wish is known as blessing. Mere wish or desire or expectation, dream is not blessing. So, merely elders, or mere parents, or merely red scholars, without having potentiality of sincerity, their mere wishes are ineffective. So, malediction, benediction, these things are oral. Apart from this, who is that? Apart from this, there are also some great skills, intellectual skills, which we want to say now. Number one is prognostication, predictive understanding. There is a cosmic rhythm, and there is a cosmic way of code. Each and every happening is connected with a code, series of actions. That may be irregular, but the irregularity is regular. Somebody asked whether the code of the world is regular. I told that it may be irregular, but the irregularity is regular. It is regularly irregular, so there is a constancy. Understanding this code and the process of deciphering and divulging the same thing for apprehension, application, and prognostication. Clairvoyance is time travel, time understanding, and also incidental understanding and causative understanding. Traveling with the tenses, traveling with tenses, traveling with the causative factors, and traveling with the incidental factors. So causative, incidental, and tensal factors are moved in clairvoyance. Then there is also multi-level adaption, adapting various things. In Sanskrit, we used to say it as Bahubhashini, Sambhashini, Vibhashini, Subhashini. Polylingualism is a person simultaneously can speak in any language, speaks about the language. Polydimensionalism is any type of faculty, any type of thing he can understand and he can speak. And polylevel understanding is any level of depth he can go to the subject. And polylingualism is entirely different from multilingualism. If you speak different languages, that is different from a person speaking the same language, but that is heard by different people in different languages. So there are innumerable skills are there. They are just for record. They are not for a demonstration, experimentation, practice, show, exhibition, etc. Those are skills are there. Intellectual skills. Then oral skills, I have already told, the power of words. Now let us come to the conclusion. What is the purpose of reading all of these things? Before coming to the purpose, there are three paranormal phenomena I want to say. One is special, second is salient, third is specific. This universe, its creation, the celestial, the rishis, the liberation, hell, heaven, all of these things are salient. Those things are far beyond the reach of our immediate necessity and purpose. Let it be silent, let you read that, recognize it, realize it, relish it, or leave it. The second thing is special, that is healing. Healing comes out of that. There are a lot of healings, like face healing, psychic surgery, touch healing, subjective healing, distant healing, energy healing, abundance healing. There are innumerable healing systems, hundreds of healing systems are there. No materials are without any materials. So these things are very much useful for us. Specific paranormal phenomena is that to gain knowledge, to gain good relations, to gain betterment in life, there are a lot of other things. So those things are possible by what is normal. If you work, you are getting the benefits. It is normal. Even if you work, you won't be getting the benefits, or somebody else will get your benefits, or some previous act of yourself will intrude in the process of getting that. All your normal execution or your normal skill is insufficient. So get the support of the paranormal, support of the lineage of God, godly, God sent, and divine institutional lineage, Acharya Parampara. By means of it, sincere loyalty, recitation, worship, commitment, sharing, compassion, service, all of these qualities will make you a good paranormal receptor, the blessings of the great person, which can be applied for human betterment. Specifically, let us forget about special and salient. So paranormalcy, one third is applicable and needed by the society even now. Wherever there is atrocity, wherever there is irreligiosity, wherever there is abnormality in the society due to political imbalances, economical imbalances, like inflation, etc., then social disharmony in the form of communal and religious clashes. Certainly we have to pray only to the divine authority to function immediately to reinstall and to replace this demonic enthronements. In the place of which there must be Satatmas, there must be real truth for you. So six reasons are there for us to understand paranormal phenomena. Number one, we must, by understanding paranormal phenomena, we will have two things. We will have two type of things. One is fear, second is comfort. If there is something apart from normal, like the king is there, the rule is there, the legal system is there, judiciary is there, our neighbors are there, relatives are there, apart from this, if there is paranormal, invisible vigilator who is governing us, who is all powerful and all knowing, we will have the fear of punishment. We will have the support of his encompassing embracement. To do something wrong, we will be having fear. And while we are in depressed, if something is paranormal, if it is believed and properly, it is utilized by means of worship, suddenly we will feel that there is somebody to comfort us, there is somebody to support us. So understanding paranormalism, the first thing is fear of doing something wrong, and at the time of depression and distress, having the thought or having the strong belief and understanding of some divine support. The second thing is to understand what it is paranormal and normal, so that lot of the so-called paranormal people of the society and dark fellows of the society can be filtered, can be understood in their limited levels. If somebody, for example, if there is a tailor, then he can stitch your cloth. It does not mean that he can do your surgery. So a person just bringing some paranormal things like kumkum, etc., or some other this inferior or filthy things, immediately they must not be thought as your philosophical guide and route for liberation. Understanding the real paranormal phenomena that classifies all of these other people and their limitations also. A person who is a doctor, he need not be an engineer for you to construct your things. If a person removes diseases by his power, he is a healer. And healing is a force of God, which need not be God. I used to say always, the hair in the tip of the tail of an elephant is not an elephant. Likewise, these paranormal phenomena is to understand the real divine energy from the so-called divine energies or pseudo-divine energies or even the semi-divine energies and the demonic energies. Often they are misapprehended and understood and approached. For that, a knowledge of distinguishing is possible by paranormal studies. And number three, to protect others and also to safeguard others, it is to be there. To develop this type of paranormal understanding, receptivity and even practice, it will be enabling us. And to create a better way of life, you are suffering due to loss. In physical body, we are suffering due to diseases and discomfort. In relations, there is a disharmony. And in all expectations, we are getting disappointment. We are getting appointments with disappointments, frustrations, etc. So in each and every walk of life, we used to get